Okay, yeah, I'm gonna use this used film because it still feels like it's got a lot of tooth to it. And I just use a laminate roller, roll some of the bubbles out. The sharpening will take care of it too. You know, this stuff, as you put pressure on it, it wants to lay out really flat. Pretty neat stuff. I've tried the wet dry paper, which is just a nightmare. You know, for one thing, it doesn't last, and also, you know, anytime you have to use that spray adhesive to hold something down, then you have to get a solvent out to clean it. You know, that 3M gold paper, if you don't leave it on too long, it'll just wipe off with a rag and some simple green. So this is 40 micron, so this is the more aggressive, this is the finer. So you can see the metal particles just kind of floating up that were left over, and you know, that's the key thing, is you got to have a cutting fluid that has a decent specific gravity. So as those little metal particles are cut, they kind of float up and they're held in suspension away from the actual cutting medium. So there's not you're not trying to drive that steel from the knife down into already cut particles. So this kind of holds them up and flushes them away. You know, this isn't quite long enough, but I'm quite confident that it's going to work just fine. I want to use the whole paper. Probably could have pulled this a little bit farther away. Here, let me see if I can get this over here just a little bit farther. There. Spin that jig on there. I can use all of the paper here. Okay, let's take a look with the ProScope and see what we got going on here. After I did a little micro adjustment on the bevel. Here's a picture. That's a pretty drastic difference between just the 220 paper. You know, the beauty of this micron paper, even though when you look at the equal grit of a 40 micron compared to like a sandpaper grit, it may seem pretty aggressive, but since each one of these particles is really accurately micron graded, you're sure that every particle on here is exactly that size, so you're not going to see these random scratches that you get off of normal sandpaper. And you know, that's especially common with wet dry paper. Yeah, look at this. Here, let me just do a little video here. Okay, so here's the planer and joiner knives after just a few passes on the 40 micron paper. You know, first I did the 150, then the 220, and you can see, look at how cleaned up this edge is starting to look already. And I haven't done any dressing on the back side yet, so it's getting right really quickly. And you know, I did make a micro adjustment on the bevel angle. But and that's good, because that helped kind of push that material that gets drug front and back off, which forms that ragged edge, and so that cut that away. You know, you don't want to bend it off. or you actually create more of a serrated edge that you have to get rid of later. But that's looking really good. So I'm gonna hit this on the 40 microns a few more while I got it here, just kind of polish it up, you know. And I still have some of these deep scratches in here, and that came from the sandpaper, because you know it just doesn't grade out the same way. So there's always going to be some random crazy scratches in there. But let me hit this with the 40 a few times, and then I'll go over here to the 20 micron. Okay, so I'm gonna come over here to the 20 micron, and again these are used sheets. I'm not even using new sheets. I think I did use these two on the Hitachi, and then the three other jet knives. So they've been hit, you know, and they're still holding up. So they're very cost effective. And you would tell that they weren't cutting, because you wouldn't see the black slurry from the tool anymore. But for planer and joiner knives, this seems good enough. I mean, you saw me, I shaved my arm with that, and it's a good solid working edge for planer and joiner. Now for chisels and plane irons, you know, with the ultimate sharpening jig, I would go much finer. Okay, so let me get the ProScope out, and let's look at this now, this after, you know, working this over with the 20 micron paper. Okay, so here is the jet knife after working it over with the 20 micron paper here. And you know, those are those little things that you're seeing there, those are the fibers off of the white rag that I just wiped it with. But you know, I got a pretty clean edge. I think it's clean enough for planer and joiner. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take these knives out, and I'm going to work the backside over with on a diamond stone, and I'm going to clean up that ragged burr off the backside, and then we'll look at it one more time and see where we are. But I think it's good enough for a joiner knife.